Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. We'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is episode 73, Time Worked. All right, today's question sent in by Thomas. Thomas is getting data from a web application where the times are coming in as text 0908A, 0445P. He needs to figure out how many hours between the two of those. And Thomas already has a formula doing this. Look, check that out. He has a question, though. Is there an easier way? Okay, anytime I'm getting a time as text, the very first thing I do is I use equal time value and throw that text in there and see if it works. Lots of formats do. That one doesn't. Okay, I like the fact that we have 0445, that leading zero. That helps a lot because what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the left of C9, comma 4. That'll get me those digits. I need to format those digits to stick a colon in the middle. So that will be the text function of that whole thing. 00, backslash, colon, 00. The backslash, colon, backslash says, hey, whatever the next character is, just stick it in at that point between the digits. So there's the text, there's the time value, 0.197. That is correct. That's about 4:45 a.m. I could change it to a time format, but I'm going to just keep working. I know that ultimately I'm going to have this back as a decimal, so I'm going to leave it where it is. I now need to get that P for PM, and so I'm going to add a space here in the numeric format, ampersand the right of our time, C9, comma 1, ampersand, in quotes, M. Didn't work. Yep, that needs to be inside the time value. There we go, 0.697. All right, I feel like I'm halfway home at this point. So I take all of those characters except for the equal sign, Control C, copy them to the clipboard, go out to the end of the formula, minus, Control V to paste, and now instead of C9, I'm going to use B9. All right, two spots. B9, 0.317. All right, that is the decimal portion of a day. I need to take that whole thing and multiply it by 24 times 24. 0.76 or 7.61. That's the same thing that Thomas's formula is getting. Great. Home. Oh no, we're not. Okay. 12:57 to 12:43. They worked past midnight. Anytime you're working past midnight, now we need to change this formula. We're going to take the mod of that whole thing up to the 24, comma 1. All right. Mod stands for, I think it's modulo or modulus. Take a number, divide it by another number, you get the integer portion and the remainder. This gives you just the remainder. So we're throwing out the whole days, getting just the remainder, and there's the exact same answer that Thomas has. All right, so is there an easier way to calculate the hours worked? I don't know if this is any easier or not. Let's take a look at the just number of characters in the formula. So here's mine, apostrophe control V. 124 characters in mine, 139 characters in Thomas's. I don't think it's marginally easier, not a whole lot easier. Hey, Mike, let's see if you have a better way to do that.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Thanks, Thomas, too. Now, totally awesome formulas. I love in particular that mod function to deal with the fact that we have night shift sometime. In both of these, the mod was used. Now, Mr. Excel went ahead and counted the characters. His formula is a little bit shorter. Let's also count the functions. And I'm just going to count the functions of that are used to coax a time out of one particular cell. So here, we won't look at those. For Thomas's 1, 2, 3, 4, so 5. Over here, Mr. Excel's 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, and so not only are we looking for less length in the formula, shorter to type out, but also fewer functions to have to run. All right, I'm going to hide these columns here, right-click Hide, and then see if I can come up with something. Now, basically, I'm going to steal most of the tricks they use. The text function, totally awesome way to go. Now, the value, we don't have the value, so we have to say, hey, left, take the left four characters. And then we're going to format that. Now, I love Mr. Excel's trick here, 0 and then a backslash. That says, I love it, insert that, which is exactly what time needs, a colon, 00, close parentheses. Now, close, double quote, close parentheses. Now, I'm going to put one less 0 because that formatting will pick up 9, 9, and 12. So that'll work just fine. Now, that, whoops. I forgot a comma. Now that gives us the 908, but we need the AM or PM. So ampersand and then right. Right of this, comma 1. That'll always get the A or the P. And then we simply ampersand join symbol and double quotes M. Now right there, that is not a proper time value. Now notice it's a line to the left. That means it's text. But if you're going to coax a number from a text string, various ways to do that, that space has to be there. So I'm going to come back over. And actually, you could prove yourself that this number would not cannot be coaxed into a, at least I don't know how. If we do any operation on text that's actually a number, it'll convert it back to a number. So I'm going to add 0. That's my any operation. It's a value. But as soon as I put that space right here, meaning time, space, and then AM or PM, boom, it'll work. Now I'm going to take this. We got the time value from there. Copy this. Copy. I'm going to need this minus this, so I'm going to Control V minus. Now I had to make sure and put all of this in parentheses if I want to subtract these two, because that ampersand is calculated after any arithmetic operator like that. So you have to force it to be calculated first by putting in parentheses. Now I'm going to change this, the later time minus the earlier time. All right, and so that will work. Now, when we copy this down, there's the problem with night shift. Now, what we really want is 1 plus this, right? Because our actual time for working is 0.499 something, something, something. So let's see how the mod function works. Mod takes a number and divides it by something and gives you the remainder. So I'm going to say, hey, there's the number and the divisor, or the denominator, is 1. Is that totally awesome? That's just unbelievable. But why does that work? Microsoft Help actually does work sometimes when you're looking at function. And here's a hot screen tip. If you click on this, boop, it'll open up Help. And if you read through Help, there's a little algorithm here. And there it is. Too small to see right here. So I'll scoop it out, copy, and then paste it. Escape right up here. And there's our algorithm. That's how it's calculated. So the n, that's that part right there, minus d, 1 times, and then our time divided by 1. Let's just go ahead and see what this divided by 1 is. Well, of course, it's just going to give us the value, right? All the way down. But what does the int function do? The int function is kind of the magic part of this algorithm. Int function takes something and gives it just the integer part. But guess what? It always goes down. So from these two numbers going down, it gets to 0, 0. But here, when it goes down, what does it go? It goes to negative 1. So here's int. So we get a 0, 0, and a negative 1. Now, if we our d is 1, so we simply 1 times, and it gives us the same thing. Oh, a 0, 0, minus 1. And guess what? When you take this, that's the n, and minus it, well, what's a minus minus when it gets down here? It's actually 1, so it takes this plus 1. And that's how we get, which we really wanted to. That's what we wanted. And so that's how the mod function works. Now let's put it all together right here. Here's that formula. I'm going to say mod. Oops. Yeah, that's right. Do I have? No, that's not right. Mod. I need one more parentheses right there. There's the screen tip number divisor. So I'm going to come here, comma 1, and then times 24. Double click and send it down. And so there we have our times. If I right click unhide. So there you go. Mostly we got to see how that mod function does its magic. I think maybe a few. Oh, it's 3 functions. So 1, 2, 3. 3 functions. All right, throw it back over to Mr. Excel.
Beautiful, Mike. Great explanation of mod from Excel Help, of all places. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.